You found it? Diabolo?
Yeah. You know, it's like...
Oh, that's what it is. It's that weird thing I see them playing with in the park.
I don't know what it calls. It's like...
Yeah.
Something like that.
Swiss juggling. I see people play with this in the park in the morning. Evolved from the Chinese yo-yo.
Yo-yo, yeah, that's what they call.
The liar. Diabolic. The devil stick.
Whatever they call.
It's the devil! It's the devil in disguise. This is a model of Xuanan.
Xuanan.
In the year 2000.
Lao Tianqiao, Old Tianqiao, commercial area.
Who's this lady?
It's the artist.
She makes music. Speaking opera.
Music. She's pretty.
These are all music instruments for making noise at festivals.
Or funeral.
Funeral.
Or funeral.
Or funeral. To scare away evil spirits?
Yes.
They say, hey, stay away. Blah, 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 blah. Like that. They say, hey, evil spirit, you go. You'll not come back. Right? Hop, 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 hop. It sound like that. Let's go in the office and we'll look at people in their desk and we'll pretend they're an exhibit. We'll go, oh, look at this.
Pretend I don't speak Chinese.
Yeah. And they'll go, no, no, no admittance. This office, museum there. And I'll go, oh, yeah, very interesting. Take their picture. I'll stick the camera right in their face. Look at that old millstone for grinding up stuff.
Yeah.
You sit there and I'll grind your feet like the foot binding we saw.
They're making medicines out of it.
Yeah? I think they're making juice.
No, it's not juice.
Yeah, it's for juice. That's for making wine or something.
No.
They use the other one for medicine, the wheel that sits vertically in the... semicircular basin. They grind up the juice, man. This guy looks like the lionfish with the spines coming out of its back. Poisonous fish. Peking opera.
Yeah, it's very famous. Peking opera house.
Operatic Trade Council. Be now by me. That's my, I can do opera.
Mei Lang Fang. Remember?
Mei Lang Fang. Yeah, we went to his house. Did you? You weren't with me when I went there, were you?
I know.
No?
No.
I don't think you were.
What else?
You been there though?
No.
You been to his museum?
No.
No? Operatic circles, popular saying goes. One walks but on the road, a tiger lives but in the hills, and an actor can live but near Han Jai Tan. Interesting. Where's that, Han Jai Tan? Han Jia Tan?
Wait.
Since mid-Qing, actors of the Anhui troops, Hebei. How do you say Hebei? Hebei? Hubei, Kangchu, opera? I've been to Kungchu. That's in Jiangsu province, yeah?
Kungchu.
In Suzhou, they had a museum right next to the Pingtan Museum, same street. Yiqiang, operatic style of the Ming, and Yiyang in Jiangxi province. Peking Opera, Clapper Opera, Hebei. I do.
This is Mei Lan Fang's birthplace. By the Xuanwumen district.
Yeah, I went to it. He was a don. He played ladies.
Yeah, because at that age, no ladies are allowed to perform.
You know why? Prostitution.
Really?
Yeah. Because the women would become prostitutes. And they tried to have young boys play a lot of the roles, and same thing, prostitution still. When Kangxi Emperor was in power, there used to be a Yuan Ming Lu, bright moonlit tower close to Yangming Temple, Eternal Light Temple, outside of Xuanwu Gate, and was considered the oldest theater in Xuan'an. During the reign of Jiaqing and Xianfang, theaters were not allowed to exist in the inner city of Beijing. Dajilan thus became the first place chosen for constructing theaters. Theaters like Qingle Yuan, San Qing Yuan, Tangle Yuan, and Zhanghe Yuan, and Guangdelu were built. Guangdelu.
It's famous. At least I know this one.
Tiangqiao. Heavenly Bridge theaters became into being in 1910. 1919, biggest theater Beijing completed, known as Number One Stage, in vogue for quite a period of time. Kaiming Theater, built at Zhu Shiku West, 1922. Guildhalls, Huguang Guildhall, Jiangxi Guildhall, Anhui Guildhall, Zhengyisi. That's near the main street that runs south from Xianmen. I tried to go to this one, this guild hall, I think. There's a small museum.
This is a very good movie.
Yeah, you seen this?
Yeah, it's one of my favorite movies.
What's it about?
It's about... Peking Opera.
The boy becomes initiated into the Peking Opera? An actor?
Something like that.
So he's learning to be an actor? Does he play a man or a woman? On stage?
I think there's a man playing a woman on the stage, but there's a lady want to perform. She
pretends to be a man.
So she can
play a woman.
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
As far as I can remember.
It's your favorite movie.
What else?
You don't remember? Fulian Cheng School. Chun Chi School? That's where we are now, isn't it? Bin Ching Shi and Rong Chun Chi. What does Chun Chi mean? Chun Chi. I see Chun Chi here. I see Chun Chi here. What does it mean?
I'm thinking about it.
Ming Chun Chi School.
Chun Chi.
Yeah?
That means a society.
Means society?
Or some kind of like a Opera house.
Bi Mao Bai Lu.
The four famous great masters. What we got?
Oh yeah.
Mei Lan Fang's.
That's Mei Lan Fang.
Yeah, and
that's him in character.
The role, yeah, in character. And the other four. We have Da Dan and Xiao Dan. Mei Lan Fang, Shang Xiao Yun.
These are the four Dons. Yeah, I read about these guys.
Cheng Jinqiu, And this one, 荀慧生. I think this is the most beautiful design, you know, the custom design.
Yeah.
And we have another four. This is Zhang Junqiu. She looks like horrible.
Who's that?
Li Shifang.
Cool.
Have a nickname of Mini Mei Lan Huang. Mini Mei Lan.
Mini Mei?
Mini Mei, yeah. And this one is Mao Shilai.
Mao Shilai.
Song De Zhu.
Song De Zhu. Aren't there like four that they say are the four great dons?
Yeah, there's a Da Dan and Xiao Dan. You know what that means?
No.
Da Dan means like a super, super artist for female player.
It's a theater? Be my low prosperity of the operatic circles. With a history of 800 plus years, traditional Chinese opera is one of three classical dramas of the world. From the professional script in the Jin Yuan periods to the tales of the marvelous, a form of drama under the Ming Qing, from the flourishing of the Kung Chu opera, to the four Anhui theatrical troupes, appearance in Beijing, Peking opera's birth to the golden age of the quintessence of Chinese culture, all these were tightly entwined with Xuanan. Each chapter or page of Peking opera's 2,000-year-old history left behind the traces here. In this fertile soil, a great many masters of Peking opera emerged one generation after another, such as Cheng Chonggang, Tan Xinpai, Yang Shailo, Mei Langfang, Ma Langfang, Ma Liang Lang, Liang Lang,
Ma Liang Lang, Ma Liang
Lang, and others. Hundreds of artists. Li Yuan Trade Council. Qian Long was 80. Song Qinghuai, theatrical troupe from Anhui province led by Gao Lang Ting, came to the capital to perform. Warmly received. Succession of visits.
Oh, we have an interpreter here.
Oh, cool. Si Shi, He Chun.
Any questions?
Chun Tai.
We can ask him.
I don't know. Chen Tai, Shan Shi, Han Zhai Tan, Shi Tao. Dao Guang Emperor. Performance is staged by the Anhui Theatrical Troops, very popular Beijing. Chu Opera and Hubei made their appearances. Embryonic form of Peking opera. 30 years hardworking efforts absorbing the movements of Kung Chu opera. Style of opera characterized by high-pitched singing to the accompaniment of percussion instruments only. Shanxi opera, clapper opera, bangji or clappers. So this is the stylistic evolution, huh, of Peking opera. Tongji, Guangxu periods. Actors of such type of opera appeared. Xuanan. 100 years hardship. The three famous Lao Sheng actors. Lao Sheng? Lao Sheng. They had a lot of this stuff on view in Hong Kong. I went to Cantonese Opera Museum. They had a lot of stage jewelry. birth of the film Ding Jun Mountain.
Ding Jun Shan. This is quite famous.
Feng Tai Photo Studio. It's famous? Mm. Dajilan's Grand View Pavilion. Da Guang Lo.
Da Guang Lo.
100 years in 2005.
I think Lao Sheng is kind of this
character. Peking Opera had its heyday from the end of the Qing to the Republic of China, huh? My log fog toward the United. Ugh, excuse me. He toured the United States. Yeah, he went on a tour of the states.
Was he popular?
I think he was pretty popular. He went to San Francisco, I think. I don't know where else. Following the 1920s, Peking opera reached its climax. Reputed as the golden age in history, Peking opera. New operas: a male role, female role, painted face role, comic role. Four main roles of traditional opera.
So like male role, female role, painted face role, comics role. Yeah.
Shrimp role, egg role.
生旦净丑. Lao Sheng, I think that is male role.
And they have shrimp roll and egg roll too, right?
I don't know.
I'm joking, you know. In the restaurant, you can have shrimp roll, egg roll, noodle.
Chicken egg.
With noodle. Say noodle. Noodle?
Noodle.
Hui. Too cold. Somebody's got to turn the heat up in Beijing. You tell them it's too cold. Tell them I said it's too cold in Beijing for me. Watch me karate kick. Yeah! I'll do karate. We start over here.
Yeah.
Famous people.
Famous revolutionaries.
Who died? Who's this? Karl Marx. No.
You know this one?
No.
Li Dazhao.
Who's that?
It's a pioneer on Chinese revolutionary. Want to have a reform in the
Against who, the Qing?
Yeah. Let me see. Li Dazhao.
Ooh, who's this?
Li Dazhao, here. Li Dazhao is a communist.
Yeah.
Marxism.
Who's this?
Sun Dongshan.
Is the Heavenly Rebellion?
Ow.
I bit my lip. Chewing gum is dangerous. I bit my lip. Fertile soil for the seeds of revolution. Xu Xilin. Qiu Jin. Sun Yat-sen. Huang Xing. Chen Dushua. Li Daozhou. Mao Zedong. Zhou Enlai. All left their footprints here, huh? I recognize three people. Sun Yat-sen, Mao Zedong, and Zhou Enlai. Enlai? Enlai? Enlai.
Zhou Enlai.
Enlai.
Li Dazhao. But now, I think you should know Li Dazhao.
Li Dazhao? What did he do? He started it all?
She is the main co-founder of Chinese Communist Party.
Hmm.
And the revolutionist. She went to Japan for, you know, study.
Yeah.
And then she joined some sort of like party.
Japan.
Japan. And she come back to China to join the new culture of movement.
She or he?
Sorry, he. He also organized some sort of Marxism study research establishment in China.
Who's the lady?
Qiu Jian.
Who's this lady? Who's this lady?
Qiu Jian. She also went to Japan for study and established Tongmang Hui Party.
Okay.
She's famous.
She's very famous.
And beautiful. And beautiful.
And very beautiful.
Yeah.
She's a lady.
A lady can do anything she wants.
Except pee standing up.
Education.
What's this?
This one?
Schools?
Someone's house.
Si He Yuan?
When?
You call this Si He Yuan?
Si He Yuan.
Si He Yuan?
Si He Yuan.
Si He Yuan?
He.
He.
Yuan.
Yuan.
Si He Yuan.
Si He Yuan.
The four tone.
I don't do tones.
So people won't understand you.
Well, too bad. They should learn English then. Because I ain't doing no tonal languages. That's just too hard. Mm-mm. I'm going to learn no tones. Opium. The motion of banning on opium smoking and the opium trades.
Lin Zhe Xu. This guy.
Yeah. The best of poetic drama. Qing poetry. Xuanan Poetry Society. Taoranting Joyous Pavilion Park, Longshu Shi, Dragon Tree Temple. Three celebrated scholars of the Qing, Feng Bao, Yao Nai.
Feng Bao.
Feng Bao, Yao Nai, Liu Dai Ku. Kui. Liu Da Kui. Tongcheng School.
This is Yao Nai's image.
Hmm. What script is this? Seal script. What's he doing?
Opium.
He's doing opium?
Sort of, maybe smoking.
He's smoking and he's doing calligraphy. That's the life. When I came through customs and they said, "Why are you here in China?" I said, "Smoke opium and do calligraphy." And I showed him a picture of this guy. And the custom agent was like, "Right on, my man." And he told me some good spots where I could score. The complete library in the four divisions. The work on compiling the complex library in the four divisions was begun with the imperial edict issued by the Qianlong Emperor, 1773. A A large number of sinologists were recruited to the Shuanan area from all over the country in order to work on this mammoth project. Laboring 10 years, collected 79,309 volumes and a variety of 3,461 books, including 93,551 volumes in 6,793 catalogs. It remains to this day a seminal work on Chinese culture. Ji Xiaolan, popularly known as the Man of Eloquence, was in charge of compiling this encyclopedia and resided at Yue Wei Cottage in Shuanan area. Have you ever heard of that? Complete Library of the Four Divisions? There was something about that somewhere. I don't know if it was when I was at the Summer Palace. They mentioned that during the great days of Kangxi and Qianlong emperors, there appeared political stability and economic prosperity under the influence of the great thinker Gu Yanwu. The Han School of Classical Philology was flourishing. I think it was at the Westlake Museum.
Yeah, it's nearby there.
They mentioned something about the books, books being compiled. It was in Westlake.
And they stole those books in Westlake or nearby there.
Yeah. Because they had a museum, that little model of the library. And like one of them burned down maybe or something.
It took 13 years for them to
complete the whole process.
Including the poetry, history books, and another two
kinds. Yeah. Because I know under Qianlong's reign and Kangxi reign, they like to go down to Westlake a lot. So it makes sense that they had stuff going on there. Open the book.
No, it's too quick.
That's how I read. I'm a speed reader. Sir He Huan. Sir He Huan. Qing Dynasty. I could be literate, but I might not be fluent. The difference between literacy and fluency in a language. The Qing Dynasty, most of the Han officials see in Japanese become fluent, but they'll never become literate. In the Qing Dynasty, most of the Han officials and noted ministers lived outside of Xuanwu Gate. Those celebrities who lived in Xuanan, southern Beijing, outside of the Xuanwu Gate were elites and eminent persons from all parts of the country. The capital's cultural environment made these people succeeding in their lives. In turn, these people left memorable stories and vestiges to the city in such ordinary lanes and alleys as Nanhang Street, Changxiang, Prime Minister Lane, and Lilichang, the residence of the famous people, blah, blah, blah. So they all like to be living in this area. This area was the players' quarters. This area was for players. Guildhall. Spiritual Link, Scholars, Xuanan. The Guild Hall. I went to a Guild Hall museum in Shanghai. Xuanan culture originated in the Ming Dynasty and flourished under the Qing. Owing to the early Qing Dynasty policy of separating the living quarters of the Manchu and the Han. What does Xuanan really refer to? Didn't really explain it.
Shenan is this place. It's called Shenan.
Yeah, but what does it mean?
Xuanwumen南边, maybe.
So we're in the Chinese section of the city. when the Qing separated the Manchu and Han, huh? And this was the Han quarter, south of the imperial city. Progressive thinkers advocated prohibition of opium, reform, newspapers, education, life and death struggles. Separation between, yeah, this is what it is. Imperial city, right?
Uh-huh.
Manchu city. For the Manchus in here. Do you know what a Fu Manchu is?
Huh?
Fu Manchu. That's like the beard, the little skinny mustache and beard that Chinese people sometimes wear, old men. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
We call it a Fu Manchu. The Qing dynasty made Beijing its capital. In order to safeguard the imperial residences, the Manchus were divided into eight banners. Within the inner city. 1648, business people residents in Beijing had to move to the southern city on imperial orders, practicing separation between Manchu and the Han. Therefore, Xuanan became the first place for the Hans to choose to live in. This created a good opportunity for Xuanan era to prosper. Gu Yanwu, born in Kunshan, Jiangsu province. Cherished ideals, blah, blah, blah. Wrote many books, profound scholar. Opposed upholding the empty talks of the Ming Dynasty. Study for the sake of application. Every man has a shared responsibility for the defense of his country. Great master of the new ideas. Academically and ideologically, Qing. Xuanan. So he was what you call a pretty big deal. In the early days of Qing Dynasty, many gentries and officials living in Xuanan. Joyful Garden. Wang Shi, number one.
Oh, right now, I know
10,000 books.
Wow.
What you looking up? Oh, the name Xuanan. The Scholar's Office. During the periods of Shunji and Kangxi emperors, princes, dukes, and ministers began to recruit men of learning on the orders of the Kangxi emperor. Gu Yanwu's nephew, the cabinet grand secretary Xu Qianshui, began to compile the history of the Ming Dynasty in his own private study named Azure Hill Hall. He attracted a large number of elite and academic circles of China. Among them were Hu Wei, Wang Zitong, Yan Ruiqu, Gu Zuyu, Li Gang. Yeah?
Yeah, Li Gang, yeah.
Sinology. Qianlong, he's a good emperor, huh? His name is always popping up.
Kangxi Qianlong.
Kangxi and Qianlong, right? Yeah. Grandfather and grandson. Guild halls first appeared, Ming Dynasty, under the Qing. Provincial metropolitan examinations held triannually in Beijing for the reception of hundreds of thousands of candidates from all over the country. Their fellow provincials or townsmen living in Beijing built multitudinous guild halls in the southern city. These guild halls were also nicknamed trial halls. Statistics show about 70% of Beijing guild halls were built within the limits of Xuanan area. The numerous guild halls offered spectacular landscape in the city of Beijing as well as a salient feature of the capital culture. Watch my video from, it shows where they all were, huh? From the imperial examination at the Confucian Temple. And talk all about this. If you wanted to be in the civil service, mm-hmm. in the Ming Qing,
mm-hmm.
you had to read all the Confucian books, right? Like 90% Confucius, I think. Right? Is that the last hall?
Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah,
we done.
It's man.
It's time to get the food to eat. It's time to get the food to eat. Candidate gone to Beijing and took examinations, but he didn't do well, so now he's gonna have to be a fishmonger. . 70% Beijing, 500 guild halls in the area of Xuanan. Nan is south.
Yeah.
Xuan is what?
Xuan.
What does Xuan mean? Xuan. What is it? What does Xuan mean?
Xuan means announcing. For example, Xuan Wuman, right? It's announcing someone that I will fight.
Guild halls were mostly financed by provincial bureaucrats. Gentry and merchants provide accommodation and learning places for candidates from the same village for free. Candidates from all areas who have gone to Beijing and took examinations concentrated on Xuanan. That's something I didn't pick up at the Confucian Museum, though. They kind of make it out like you have to travel at your own expense.
They don't need to pay for the residence, you know? They need to pay.
And that was one of the reasons that only rich people could become civil servants, really, because it was expensive to come to Beijing and take the test. 1648, Qing government adopted separation policy on Qi, that guild halls were not allowed to build in the inner city, causing provincial guild halls concentrated here. 1415 is when they stopped giving it in Nanjing, and they started giving it in Beijing, right? The southern capital. All right.
Oh, so much for today.
It's time to go. It turned out kind of nice now, huh? Sun came out.